did this last week. Should be good. And put some rumba music on for maybe one song.
Yep. Yeah, just to
break the awkward silence.
Break the awkward silence. Get into thinking of the song.
All the way to change my plans. For being the perfect distraction. For the way you took the idea that I had. Of everything that I wanted to have, it made me see there was something missing. Oh yeah. For the ending of my first beginning. Yeah, yeah, oh, yeah, yeah. And for the rare and unexpected friend. Something that I never choose, but at the same time, something I don't want to lose and never want to be without ever again. You're the best thing I never knew I needed. So when you appeared, I had no idea. The best thing I never knew. Now it's so clear, I need you here. Oh, yeah. My ex said they don't have to leave ever after. Oh, the way you smile and how you come to me with your laughter. I must admit, you were not a part of my book. But now if you open it up and take a look, you're the beginning and the end of every chapter.
All right, so we're gonna hop to it and get started with our beginner rumba lesson. Once again, I'm Bailey. I'll be leading tonight. And again, I'm Abby, and this is playing. There we go. Sorry. Music. Nice. So yeah, tonight we're going to be using the paracord for our connection in order to keep a safe 6 foot distance while we dance. Can I get a quick input on whether you are dancing with a partner in person or whether you are dancing either solo or distanced?
We have one dancing solo.
Okay.
Both do not have partners.
Okay, that'll be interesting this week. So all of these moves you're going to be able to do, you're going to be able to practice alone. So when eventually you may have a partner that you can put these moves together with, or just get the steps, get the foundations ready. And it's still a lot of fun to just dance by yourself and feel the music. So we're going to start. We're going to do a quick demo on the moves we're going to be teaching tonight.
Tangled up in you. Yeah.
in your clothes, where I'll follow you go. I worry I won't see your face light up again. Even the best fall through sometimes. Even the wrong words seem to run out of the doubt that fills my mind. But somehow find you and I collide. I'm quiet, you know.
A demonstration of what we're going to be teaching tonight. So the first part that we're going to focus on is our basic box step. So in rumba, this is going to be the step that you're going to keep coming back to and keep practicing throughout the dance. And even if you don't learn any other moves, if you can learn the box step, you can rumba to any sort of music and you can really enjoy, feel the rhythm, feel the music, and have a lot of fun dancing rumba. So this is gonna be your foundational step. So we're gonna start, I'm guessing we're gonna, well, let's start with the follow part tonight, with the follow of the basic box.
Okay, so for follows, so like your lead will be like stepping forward towards you. So you will start with your right foot up and free, ready to move. And it's gonna be in a slow, quick, slow formation. So you go back step on your slow, and then with your left foot, you kind of make this diagonal back to your left, quick, and plant with your right foot. And now you have your left foot free, and complete the box with a slow, and then a quick. So if we all like do it kind of together, we go back on the right, slow, left, right, left for slow, right, left. And that's just kind of the general gist of the follow for the basic step.
So I'm just going to build on that. So we have, let's think about on the ground, you can draw yourself a little box. And you're going to picture yourself, you're standing in the sort of top right. You're standing in the top right corner of that box that you've created. You kind of draw it on the ground. So we're going to, with our feet, we're going to be following that box all the way around, and that's why it's the box step. So with our right foot, we're going to have, a lot of the Latin dances revolve around the shifting of weight. So when your right foot is free, as it is on our first beat for follows, our left foot is going to be planted and our right knee is going to be bent. So all our weight is on our left foot, and our right foot is free to move around. It's all bent, ready for that first beat. So on beat one, our right foot is free, and we take a step back. And then our left foot follows it back and to the left. And then our weight shifts back to our left foot. So our weight from there is planted with our left. Step back, plant on your right. Plant to the side with your left, and then bring our feet together. And then we're going to not move, but we're going to shift our weight from our left to our right foot with our feet together. And that's going to be the first half of our box step. So the first half is going to be that slow back step, side, together, shift weight. And how that's gonna work, how that's gonna be with the music, with the rhythm, is gonna be slow, quick. And then on that next slow, we're going to step forward and complete our box. We're gonna step forward with our left, step to the right with our right foot, together, switch weight. So let's go through that really slowly all together, but with that, some of that rhythm there. And then I'll face the wall so you guys can follow me and just do what I'm doing. And you don't have to deal with trying to switch or do mirrors in our heads or whatever. So we're gonna start, our right foot is free, and we're gonna start on that back step. So it's gonna be slow, quick, together, switch weight, slow, left, together, switch weight, slow, quick, quick, switch, slow, quick, switch, slow, quick, quick, 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 slow, quick, quick.
So that is going to be our follow box step. When you're dancing this with a lead, the lead is going to be doing the same footwork, but they're going to start on that forward step with their left. So like Abby mentioned before, your lead is going to be stepping towards you while you step back with your right foot. And you're going to be doing the same thing. It's going to be a mirror. Not quite a mirror. It's going to be, what is it? Look. You're going to be moving together. Back and forth and side to side. So we're going to start, we're going to do some dancing of that box step together. And let's put on some music and we all can practice that box step. So the rhythm, you're going to be thinking, listening to the song.
Now I think of when we were together, like when you said you felt so happy you could die. Told myself that you were right for me, but felt so lonely in your company. But that was love and to make us still remember. Like resignation to the end, always the end. So when they found we could not make sense, well, you said that we would still be friends. But I'll admit that I was glad it was over.
Should our steps
be? How big should our steps be? That will actually depend on how much space you have generally, and how fast the song is. So that dance we were just doing was quite fast for a rumba, I think. So when you're dancing, you know, if we were able to be dancing in like a crowded ballroom, those are the days. But you would have to like find your own space and like carve out your little space. And you could take very small steps. You could take even like maybe a heel to toe kind of size steps. And this could be your box and just very delicate and tiny. Or if the song is slow and you want to really spread out, you have lots of space, you could take, I wouldn't go longer than like a shoulder width step. But if you wanted to take much bigger steps for a slow song, where you have lots of space to move around, you can really spread out.
And then when you get like kind of the gist of how the basic step goes, since it is a Latin dance, it has like a lot of like hip movement. So if you want to like put a little sway in your walk, and it kind of adds and makes the dance look a lot more natural and just flowing.
So the way I like to practice the hip movement, because I love the hip parts of rumba, I think the hip movement really makes the rumba really fun and special, is you work on that weight shift. So starting with our feet one, our right foot is free, and we're just gonna practice our weight changes with sort of our hips. So if we have our right foot kind of cupped, we can switch our weight, and it kind of, you know, when your weight is on your left foot, then your hip kind of pops out to the left, just sort of naturally. So if you want to practice moving your hips for rumba, you can kind of practice just doing those weight changes. So weight on the right, kind of hip pops out to the right a little bit. Weight on the left, hip pops out to the left a little bit. I'll be right back to get our legs.
Oh yeah.
So if you want to just
technical difficulty.
A couple weight shifts.
Oh yeah.
Get those hips moving, because those are really fun to just practice.
So
that movement is really fun. So it's gonna be. You're just doing a little walk in place, little steps, really accentuating those hips. And then once you've kind of gotten used to that movement, you can work that into your box. So step back, shifting our weight to our right foot, and that right hip goes out a little bit. Hip goes out a little bit to that left foot. That's that. I'm exaggerating my hips. I probably wouldn't. I feel like it would be a little bit silly if I went. But basically, whichever foot is free, you're gonna kind of lean your hip into the other side. And throughout this, you don't wanna, your shoulders, a mistake a lot of beginners make is when they're working on their hips, their shoulders do kind of like this as they're moving their hips. And you really wanna keep your shoulders relaxed and loose and down. You gotta, for posture is kind of important to dance. Do you wanna have a straight spine, a relaxed shoulders and chest area, chest up a little bit, and then chin up. So you have a nice straight elevated posture, and all the movement is gonna be happening down in the feet and the legs and the hips. For arms are kind of fun to work into rumba. Especially if you're not dancing with a partner, your arms are really free to bring in that sort of expression. Normally, if you're dancing with a partner, you would want to have a handhold. And the handhold we use for rumba, the one we typically are going to be using is the chips in the salsa. It's an open frame. So we call it the chips in the salsa because the leaders make the bowls of salsa.
And then the balls are like the chips that dip their hands into the bowls.
So what you're gonna get from that is you're going to get a, you know, a solid, but also flexible fingertip to fingertip connection. And that makes it easy for the leader to communicate the next moves to the follow. And it also allows for turns and other fun stuff without the follow being feel like they're being yanked around at all. So we just went through a lot of stuff. We went through arms. I think the best way if you're dancing solo to use your arms. We're going to be forming sort of a bent arm, relaxed shoulders, relaxed arm, and then when we get to the elbow, our elbow is going to be at just over a 90 degree angle. So you're going to have sort of sort of robot arms, not quite. Keep it loose and relaxed. And as you're dancing, feel free to have a little bit of that circular movement. But you want to have your hands out in front of you, your elbows at just more than a 90 degree angle. And just let your arms kind of relax and express yourself and the music you're feeling and that expression. And that's gonna look really nice and feel really good. So we've gone through the box step. We've gone through kind of the staples of our frame and our hips and our arms for rumba. So let's try out another basic step that is going to incorporate with our music. This is another one where you're just gonna be dancing in place and feeling the rhythm of the music. And we call this one the side basic. It's also called second position breaks. And I think this one is even easier than our box step basic. And it's going to look like this. We're just gonna demonstrate how it looks real quick. I'm gonna be doing a box step first and then getting into the side basic step. So slow, quick, quick, 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 slow. So let's break that down. Abby, why don't you go first and explain how that side basic is going to work?
Okay, so to get into it, it will be like on the slow, quick, quick, slow, on like the quick, quick, I guess. So rather than going back to your right corner after finishing like your box, because you go to your like one end of the box, and now you see it as you're traveling over to the right side of the box to complete it, then you bring it back on the slow count, and then do another quick, quick on like the outside. So if we put it together, we do our like three quarters of a box, like slow, quick, quick, slow, quick, quick, slow. So, and that's how you kind of start to get into it. And now you're in the standing position and you just kind of feel the rhythm. And on that little quick, quick, do a little side step, get a little hip movement in there. Mm-hmm. And you just kind of follow your partner along with it, yeah.
So yeah, so for the actual movement of how that side basic is going to feel, once you get into it, the basic movement, I think it's a lot easier to sort of think of than the box step, because we're just shifting weight to the side. We're shifting our weight a little bit, but we're not taking a full step. We're not stepping side to side at all. What we're doing is we're just pushing off our foot and then back to center. Shift weight, pushing off to the side, together, shift weight. And the way this is gonna look is it's going to be a quick, quick, slow, shift weight. Quick, quick, slow, shift weight. Slow, quick, quick, slow. Quick, quick, slow, quick, quick, slow. So for the pushing off, I kind of think of it, this is a little bit gross, but I think of it like you saw like a cockroach or something on the floor next to you, and you take your foot and you don't wanna step. You're not gonna lift your other foot off the ground. You're just gonna use your toe and you're gonna put a little bit of your weight on it and then push away back to center. So you just kind of give it a little push off, but you're not going anywhere. A little push off, back, and then the other side. Quick, quick, slow. Quick, quick, slow. Quick, quick, slow. For leads and follows, this is going to be the same footwork, but it's going to be mirrored. So when I step to my left, this is going to start with me stepping to my left, and the follow will step to their right. So we're doing it together as sort of a mirror. Quick, quick, slow, quick, quick, slow, quick, quick, slow, quick, quick, slow. I really think this is a fun one just to feel the music and dance even by yourself or with a partner. And see, we don't even have the chord connection this one. It's more of a visual lead. And you can dance away from somebody or with a hand-to-hand connection with somebody, however your situation demands. So now we're going to show you how we got into that from the back step. Abby got into a bit of the follow part, so let's just work through how it's going to look together. So we're going to start with our box step with that slow step forward, quick together, and then slow. And here's where it's going to be changed up. So the follow is stepping forward on their left, the lead is stepping backwards with our right. And then instead, so we take that next side on our quick, but instead of bringing our feet together, instead of putting our weight on our follows right, lead left, instead of bringing that back to that leg, we're just going to say, oh no, we changed our minds. Instead of going this way, we're just gonna stay right where we are. And then we bring it to the other side, let's go that way, change our mind back to center. And this will be how we get into that. And as for how we get out of it, so it'll be on your, you will just have taken
a right step front follow.
Yep.
And after like you do a quick, the lead will try to show you to like go backwards, so rather than having the slow be like you're planting, so like you're going quick, and then instead of putting your feet together, you take your right foot and go backwards and begin your box again as if you're in that right corner.
Yep. So it's since our step side step slow, quick, slow, quick, slow, last one, quick, slow. Now back to box, quick, slow. And on that slow step, it'll be leaders will just have taken a side step with their left on the quick, and then the slow goes forward and we begin the box step. And then it's the other way for the follow. The quick will be with their right. So it'll be a quick, slow step back. If you're dancing with a partner, the leads will communicate this through the handhold. So if you're leading, or if you are, I guess as a lead, what I do to signal returning to the box from the side basic is I give it almost a push, but I release the tension between our arms and the contact, especially using the paracord. It's really important to have tension between the contact between the two dancers. And when this gets relieved, the follow knows that they can step backwards on the next slow to begin the box step. Another signal that is important for this box to side basic to box is when we're beginning the box, the lead will just have stepped back on the slow, follow will just have stepped forward. And what the lead will do is bring their arms, bring the connection slightly to their side, slightly to that right side, so that signals to the follow that they should not continue to their left or right.
Right.
They shouldn't continue to their right, my left. They should stay with that foot that they've already planted and change their minds and bring it back to center to begin that side basic. So we went through a lot there. Let's go through one of those without music. We'll start with the box step and we'll enter into the side basic and back into the box step. And we'll show, well, let's all do this together and I'll count out the slow quick. Actually, I'll have you count out the slow quick, and I'll kind of talk through what's happening.
Okay. So slow, quick, slow, quick, slow.
We'll do one more box.
Slow, quick, slow, quick,
So now I'll bring my hands over.
Quick step.
We'll start that side basic.
Quick, quick, slow. Quick, quick, slow.
One more.
Quick, quick, slow. Quick, quick, slow.
And now it's going to be quick, quick, quick. I release tension. And that goes back into our
quick step. Quick, slow. Quick, quick, slow. Quick, quick, slow. Quick, quick, slow. Quick, quick, slow.
So that's going to be our box step and side basic. Let's play a little bit of music so we can practice going between the two of those. And then afterwards, we'll touch base and see if there's any questions, anything you need help with.
Actually don't know. I can look it up on Google if you want.
I believe it's Cuban.
It appeared in the East Coast during the 1930s, and it combines American big band music with the Afro-Cuban rhythms, primarily the son of Cubano, but also conga and rumba.
Wait, what? Rumba's the son of rumba?
I'm guessing primarily the son of Cubano, but also conga and rumba. So I'm wondering, she says nice.
Nice. Yeah, I'm not super familiar with sort of the history of rumba. I believe it is Cuban in origins, and it really, is it one of the standard dances?
It is a ballroom dance, yes.
Okay, so it is it American, there's an American, is there American rumba?
It is, I don't think so. I'll pull up the Wikipedia page.
Asking all the hard questions out here.
Mm-hmm.
seeing anything about that. I can keep reading and type it in the chat if I see anything.
Yeah, we'll have to look into that. I think rumba is really fun to dance, especially in better circumstances. I think it's a great partner dance when you're not so far apart, but we can still do a lot even with our chord connection and even dancing solo. So we're gonna jump into the next move. Our next moves are going to be crossover breaks. And we're gonna start those from we'll demonstrate those and then we'll get into how they're done. Slow, quick. So those are what our crossover breaks are going to look like, and they're characterized by that sort of parallel motion where we're turning the same direction and our inside foot goes together and then we bring it back. It's also, even with the chords, it's fun to be able to switch hands and kind of do some arm styling with our free hand. So we'll get into how the feet are gonna look for those crossover breaks. Do we wanna start with the lead or the follow for this one?
I think the lead can start with this one.
Okay, sure. So to get into these, we're gonna start from our box step. So it's gonna be the slow, quick. And then on that next slow, instead of taking our step back with our right that we would normally do, we're going to take a step directly to the side again, just like we just did. So that starts, I'll do that one more time. So it's going to be that slow, side together, side. And then from that side, our weight is on our right foot and our left foot is free. And with our left foot, we're going to take a step to the exactly diagonal at sort of a 45 degree from our body, and I call these cross steps. So if you are facing a wall with two corners in your room, you're going to be pointing your toe to the right corner. So it's going to be a shift weight cross step and then side. So all we've just done there is we started the basic, so slow, quick, side, diagonal, cross, step, side. And we're going to continue this again with our right foot. So we're going to do another cross step. That right foot is going to go across our body diagonally into that other 45 degree angle corner of our room. And that cross, step, side. And that motion is going to continue for the rest of the time that we're doing these crossbody leads. It's going to be quick, quick, slow. So let's go through the follow footwork and then we'll learn how we're going to put those two together.
So with the follow, to get into it, you do your half box, your slow, quick, and then instead of going forward on your next step, your lead will motion you to go sideways. So you take a slow step with your left foot going out, and then with your right foot, again, you go diagonal, and now you're going towards the left corner, so your right foot is diagonal towards you, and so you have like your quick out, and then you have like your feet back together. And then you just repeat it on your left side. So then you have your left going over your right and you come back together. So if we have that together, it's just like slow, quick, slow, quick together. So it's very similar to the lead, just opposite. So instead of starting out here with your left foot as the lead does, it's out with your right and you just follow them along with it. And if you want to do that all together, we can get a little like slow, quick, slow, quick, slow. quick out, diagonal together, and then diagonal together. And then to get out of it, you just do like,
we're gonna get into a really fun combo that lets us get out of this, and it looks really flashy and fun.
Ooh.
So we're just gonna start with this regular cross body and a couple of repetitions, and then in a little bit we'll show you how a really fun way to get out of it. So let's put it together, because it is a little bit interesting the way that it goes together. Because this is where our arms come in, this is where it's really gonna be more expressive, and you're gonna be able to feel the dance when you put it with a partner. So we're gonna start. This one, we're going to have only one contact point. We can have, the best way to do this is to have our contact, whether it's a handhold or the paracord, in our left hand, my left hand,
and my right hand.
Follows right hand. This hand right here. And then other arm is free. So we're gonna start that box. We're gonna do slow, quick, and then sigh. And then in order to kind of bring this in, our arm going with the contact is going to go forward. And our free arm kind of goes up. There's a couple different ways to do arm styling. The best, I think, you just shoulder goes up. I like to hold my hand like this. I think this is kind of a proper arm hand position. With the
yep.
And that just kind of goes out. You can have your elbow bent a little bit, but it's really just gonna be how the music feels to you and kind of express yourself. So arm out with that rock step side. And on our side step, we're facing each other once again. And when we're facing each other, we're gonna switch our contact point. So with our paracord, we're gonna be passing our paracord to the other side. If you're actually with a partner and you're holding hands, you can meet both of their hands, and then on the cross step, release to do our cross step side. So you notice when I was doing the feet, I wasn't moving my shoulders so much, but it is important. You are going to be moving your shoulders along with, you're going to be moving your whole body with this one.
It's a whole body movement.
It is a whole body movement. Instead of, it might look a little bit, you can still, if you just keep your shoulders facing each other, it's a little bit awkward.
It's like, hello.
So this isn't nearly as fun, but if you really get into it and you actually turn your whole body, you can rotate and then rotate. Those are some crossbody leads. I think those are
crossover breaks.
Crossover breaks. Yes, those are.
We wish we could teach you a crossbody lead.
I wish we could teach you a crossbody lead. Those are fun. They're a little bit too.
The radius gets too big, and you kind of end up whipping the follow.
Yeah.
With our paracord situation.
Yeah, it would be. It would. Yeah.
Colin and someone tried it, and it didn't end well.
That would be. Yep.
So we're not doing that today.
Maybe another time. But so yeah, when it crossover breaks is what we're actually doing. That's the name that I was trying to say. So let's put on some, or should we, let's move it with some time. Let's do it all together.
Okay, yeah.
So we're gonna have one hand, we're gonna start from the box, slow, quick, slow, quick, slow. Quick, slow. How are we feeling on that? Do we need a practice time, or can we, would you like to start with the combo that's going to be a little bit flashier and bring you out of those cross bodies?
Crossover breaks.
Crossover breaks. That's
I got you.
Called.
When I feel good.
I feel good. Good to hear.
Ooh. Doing good out there. Keep it up.
How about you, Suzanne? Feel good.
Great. And where are we at for time also?
It is 6:04.
Okay. Great.
I feel good about that.
So now we're going to demonstrate our combo that we have.
Yeah. Slow, quick, slow.
And that brings us back into our box. And there's a lot of steps to that, but I promise it is a lot easier than it looks.
Just a lot of stepping. You got it. Footwork.
It's not even that much. You're doing... I thought it was going to be hard to remember the steps. I learned this very quickly. It's not that difficult. Do we want to start with the leader of the follow footwork?
You can do it first. Yeah, lovely.
All right. So we start this the same way we started going into our crossover breaks. I'm going to step over this way. So we start with that slow, quick, first half of the box, side, cross, step, side. This time we don't change our hands, but we do a cross, and instead of going back, we go forward. We continue in the same direction. So we can, for the lead, it's going to be continuing to the left. So just to recap that, slow, quick, quick, side, cross, step, side, cross, change, and then we're going to take a step back. We're going to do another cross, but this time instead of crossing in front, we're going to cross behind with our right foot. Cross.
Cross, side, back, through.
Side, back, through.
Slow, quick, quick, side, cross, step, side, cross,
forward,
change,
side,
back.
We'll just stop there. That's a good place to start out with. Why don't we do that from the follows perspective?
Up to that point?
Yep, okay. Up to that point there.
So for follows, you're doing your half a box that you go back on your right side together, and then with your left foot, we are going to go out into those side breaks. And then we go out together, and then we go out with our left. And then instead of going together on this one, we're going to go out and then step to the side and then go back again. And that's where we left off on the leads part as well. So
to talk through that, we're doing the same thing. We can do this at the same time.
Yeah.
It's going to be...
So half a box.
Half a box, side
together,
side,
diagonal,
cross, step side, cross, continue,
and back.
Cross behind. That's where we've gotten. And then
we do a little rock step on your inside foot. And don't put like all of your weight on it, just a little like bounce off to get you like that momentum you need to go into the next part.
So it's another cross back,
then you lead with that right foot again, and then we get into the spin where
side
and you like
pivot,
rotate,
side
together,
return.
So if we go through that a little slower,
let's work on that pivot turn, because that might be the most challenging part of this.
Yeah. So when we're going in from that rock step, so we go in and then we take our right foot and go forward, and we're gonna rotate 90 degrees with your left, then you keep going, and now you're facing. So initially when you take this rock step forward, you're facing the wall, and now we pivot from our left foot and go 180 degrees. And now you're going to go another 180 degrees with your right foot as you take a step over here, and then side together. And okay, so if we put that all together, we have a little like rock step forward, out, pivot, turn, another turn, side together. If that makes sense.
We'll just keep drilling that. I feel like that one takes a little bit more.
Yeah.
So it is. It's going to be kind of that back, step, forward, side, pivot, side, facing behind, and then it's one, quick, slow.
And once you like finish your turn, you're gonna realize you have this awkward quick that you don't know what to do with, and you'll do a little like march to get over the quick. So like after you finish your turn, go into here on the slow, so you have like a slow, and then it's quick, and then go back into the slow and continue with your box.
So you should finish, and you should have planted on your left foot.
Yes,
will be planted. My right foot will be planted. And then it'll be the quick. So you're gonna do a left, right, slow, back to the box. Let's keep working on that turn, because that I feel like we can still do a little bit more work on that. We're going to be
a little rock step forward.
So rock step on the inside foot.
On the inside foot.
Rock step forward. Pivot inside first, face your partner.
So this is a clockwise turn. So it's like over your right shoulder, if that makes sense, yeah?
I hate describing turns. Turns, which direction to turn is always difficult to explain.
Mm-hmm. I always think of it, whatever foot I plant, oftentimes that shoulder is going to be the point that I spin around. So if I'm planting my left foot, my right shoulder is going to travel further.
Mm-hmm.
If I'm planting my right foot, my left foot's going to travel further.
And which one is this?
This is your left foot planting.
Well, for you, it'd be your right foot planting as the lead. So then your back is will be like that. Yeah. So then you'll be spinning over your left shoulder going counterclockwise.
Right. So why don't you face the mirror, face the mirror and do the turn.
Okay, so we go back on the right as a follow. So a little rock step forward. Now put your left foot out, pivot, turn 180 degrees. Now I'm facing you guys. And then take your right foot, go behind you, and turn again. And now you're facing back the original way you are. And then with your left foot, finish off another 90 degrees so that you're facing your partner once again. And then you do your march, and go back into the box. If that makes sense.
Yeah, I felt like that was explained really good. I feel like that was a good angle on that. Let's do that one more time, and we'll do it at the same time together.
Mm-hmm.
So let's, actually, I kind of want to have it moving to like the side so you can see everything that feet are doing this way. So if you want to, which way are you gonna be moving this way?
Should I move that way? Okay, right? Okay, so if I go like that. So you do your rock step.
Well, like, okay,
yeah,
but
like that. So yeah, I feel like this way.
Other way, though. So come over here and then
Should I go that this way? As the ball or the lead portion?
As the ball.
Okay, yeah.
Do what you did before.
Yeah, okay. So we rock step on our right foot, then go forward, left, pivot turn 180 degrees over your right shoulder. So you're going towards your right, and then take your right foot and swing it over, and now pivot another 180 degrees, and then left foot in front, and then 90 degrees. Now you're facing your partner once again, and then march. Put your feet closer together, because sometimes your feet can have odd spacing when you're trying to turn in time with the music if it's too fast. So like the distance of your feet will change depending on song.
You've probably noticed that this move does cover a lot of ground. So one way to kind of help with that is to take smaller steps during this move. Or if you have lots of space, I mean, we have the whole dance studio to ourselves. We can take as big a steps as we want.
But also you need to be aware, if you're dancing with a partner, aware of the side steps that your partner is taking so that you stay at the same time. So it's gonna be kind of the lead's responsibility to set that pace, and the follow should pay attention to how big a steps the lead is taking and follow suit so they don't get too far ahead or behind. So let's start over at the beginning and
try to put together.
Yeah, try and put things together, sort of recap the rest of the dance. So we're gonna start that half basic. So slow, quick, sigh, regular cross, over, sigh, cross, change, back, rock, step, forward, side, pivot, side,
pack together. Yeah.
So it's slow, rock, set, not slow, march, go.
Yeah. So if we put this in a quick, slow formation from the beginning, so slow, quick, slow, quick, slow. Quick, slow. March, back in your box.
Quick, slow, box steps.
Quick, slow. Yeah.
Do we have any questions on that? Any parts we need taken over again, take it a little bit slower? Otherwise, I think now would be a good time to play some music and have you practice that at your own pace and then come back with any questions from there.
One thumbs up for some practice music.
So, ready to
dance. All right, ready for practice music.
I'm close behind.
Want more music or move on?
But that wasn't a full song. Was it a full song?
Nope, it was like a minute and a half.
Right. So if you want another minute or two to give that a little bit more attention, give that a little bit more practice, this one really sinks in with a little bit of practice. Mm-hmm. And it's just thinking about, you know, which foot is going to be crossing in front and crossing behind. So it's those little details, and once you get it right once, it's a lot easier. So I want you guys to have time to get that in.
I think we're gonna put in another song.
Great.
Okay, awesome. We love rumba.
Listen, baby. Ain't no mountain high, ain't no valley low, ain't no river wide enough, baby. If you need me, call me, no matter where you are, no matter how far. Don't hurry, baby, just
just call my name. I'll be there in a hurry. It's all that you worry. Oh, baby, there ain't no mountain high enough. Ain't no valley low enough. Ain't no river wide enough to keep me from getting to you, babe. Remember the day I set you free. I told you you can always count on me, darling. From that day on, I made a vow. I'll be there when you want me, some way, somehow. Oh, baby, there ain't no mountain high enough. Ain't no valley low enough. Ain't no river wide enough to keep me from getting to you, babe. No, no, darling. No wind, no rain, no. This is cold. It's not me, baby. No, baby. Just you and I, girl. I'll be there on the double. Just watching for me, baby. I love you so much. Down in my heart. I'm gonna be the magic to fire with you for me. Help me, hey, I'll be there by the double, just as much as I can. Cause you know that there ain't no mountain high enough. Ain't no valley low enough. Ain't no river wide enough. Keep me from getting to you. Don't you know that there ain't no mountain high enough.
So that was a good little dancing time for you guys. I hope you kind of figured out the demo a little bit. Do we have any questions?
I think next up, we're going to be practicing parallel steps, which are another fun. It's going to be a similar thing to the crossover breaks, but it's going to be a little bit different with that. We're going to have a double handhold. So let's try out those parallel steps. We're going to demonstrate what they're going to look like, and then we'll break it down into lead and follow footwork. Slow, quick, quick, slow, quick, quick, slow, one basic, slow, quick, slow, quick, slow, quick, slow, quick, quick, slow. And from parallels, we're also going to practice some reverse parallels, which are pretty similar. And it makes it so the lead and the follow part, we're going to be doing the same things. But what I do in the reverse parallels, our follow is going to be doing in the regular parallels, and vice versa. Let's break that down. Why don't we do the follow footwork first, and then I'll break down the lead footwork.
Okay, so it's pretty similar to how we did those like breaks before, but now instead of going forward, you're going to take a step back. So how we're going to go about that, so you do your half box, you're slow, quick, quick. Instead of going forward, you take your step over to the side as we're going to travel over here. But now instead of going forward like we did before, now we're going to take a step backwards and then back together on slow. So if we go slow, quick, quick, slow, quick, quick, slow. So I think we kind of have like a similar thing. And then after we do your back there a couple of times, then you may be your hands will kind of move. The lead will motion you, and we'll be able to get more into that. So you'll be on your rock step instead of going back to your side and going backwards again. Now you're going to be going forwards. So you kind of have this like little march going. So you do your little backward steps, and now you just kind of walk and strut a little bit on the dance floor, and then now you're going forward. And this is similar to like what we were doing before, but that's the reverse, if you want to get more into it.
So yeah, that was a quick overview of our follow footwork. Now I'm going to go through the lead footwork. Even if you're not leading, it's going to be useful to follow along with how the lead is going to look, because you're going to be doing these motions also for the reverse. So when we start, I'm going to start facing away towards the mirror so that you can see, follow along with what I'm doing. This part is going to be, to start off, we're going to just do the half basic. So forward, side, together. And then just like in those crossover breaks, we're going to do that side, and then cross, step, side. Cross, step, side. So that's pretty much, it's going to be pretty much the same as the lead part in the crossover breaks and the follow part as well. Where, let's do that one more time. So forward, side, together, side, cross, diagonal, step, back, side, shoulder width apart, and then cross on the other side, side, shoulder width, cross, step, side. And now, for the reverse footwork, that's going to start with, we're going to be on our right leg is free, and we're going to do a cross, step, side, and then, but instead of the side, this one we're going to take a little tiny step backwards. Normally we would change positions and do another forward cross with our left foot, but for the reverse, we're going to take a backward step with our left foot. And it's going to be cross, backward, diagonal, and then side for the slow. Quick, quick, slow. Step behind, side. Step behind, side. Quick, quick, slow. Quick, quick, slow. So I'll go through kind of all that footwork together. We'll do two regular parallels and then two reverse parallels. So it's going to be slow, quick, quick, side. Quick, quick, slow. Quick, quick, slow. One more. Quick, quick, slow. Quick, quick, back. Back, step, side. Back, step, side. Back, step, side. Back, step, side. That's what those lead footwork is going to look like for those parallels and reverse parallels. So now we can sort of put it together, and we're going to figure out what we're going to be doing with our hands and what we're going to be doing with our shoulders, because our shoulders are kind of important for this one. So we're going to have a double hand hold. So that one's going to be a little bit different from our crossover breaks and our crossover break combo turn that we've worked on. So we're going to have a double hand hold. We're going to have some tension in here so that we can feel and we can communicate across the contact. So we're going to start with that half basic, slow, quick, quick, side. The lead, in order to direct your follow to take a step back instead of going into those crossover breaks, is we're going to gently increase tension on our right hand, their left, and release tension on our left. So we're going to be turning our shoulders along with this pull. So we're going to turn the face slightly to the right as we increase tension on the right, release tension on the left. And as we do this, we're going to take our first cross step with our left and then bring it side. And when we're at our side, we should be pretty much flush, just parallel to our partner once again. And then we're going to do the reverse for the next parallel. So we're going to increase tension on our left, release tension on our right, and we're going to turn our shoulders so that our body is sort of facing our left side as we cross over with our right foot. So do you want to go through what that is like from the follow's perspective? We'll start from the beginning there.
So first into a basic step, slow, quick, quick, and then we go out to the side, and you will be having tension on your left hand, pulling you forward, and then your right hand, you'll notice how, oh, it's like a little looser, and that means like don't go forward because like he's trying to like push you back. So you like take your back step forward and then you switch it, and now you're facing the opposite direction with your right hand with tension and your left hand loose. So you just kind of go along with that until they lead you to a reverse.
So for the reverse, so we kind of have this, we're exaggerating, but it's sort of almost a hammerlock position where my left arm is bent and my right arm is straight, and then opposite, or
yeah, right arm is straight, left arm bent.
It's actually the same.
Yeah, look at that.
same directions there, but we're going to keep this position. We're going to, instead of, so this one we've just done a cross step. Instead of going flush, going facing each other, in order to transition into parallels, we're gonna keep this exact position, keep our shoulders angled, our whole bodies are gonna be angled. And we're gonna be taking that step back on our left, and then it's gonna be, it's gonna be that cross step, side, cross, step, side. So let's go through that transition from a follow perspective.
So now we're going backwards and you feel this tension normally. Here, let's just keep going. You're almost here. And then when they start not releasing tension on that right hand of yours, you'll notice to take a step forward instead of sideways with your left foot, and then with your right, instead of going behind like you normally do, then you go forward again, drop step, and now you're flush with each other once again, and then you go into these reverse, it's like fairly easily if led right or something along that those lines.
Okay. Yeah, so let's go through that slow once again. Why don't you count slow quick, and I'll kind of talk through what's happening.
Slow, quick, slow, quick, slow, quick, slow, quick, slow, quick, slow, quick, slow.
So these are regular parallels. One more.
Quick, slow.
And then for reverse parallels, we're not going to change the angle, but we're going to change the reverse our direction. So when I was stepping forward, I'm stepping back, and now the follow is doing those steps forward. So the way that we are going to get out of this back into our basic is the easiest way to get out of it is from the reverse parallels. So once you start those parallels, you'll want to continue into those reverse parallels. And from those reverse parallels, let's get into those. So quick, reverse parallels, quick, slow. From here, you're able to do a quick, slow.
And go back into your box.
And that'll start the box. That quick is to get back on the rhythm, so you can start that basic on the right point in time. The important part, the lead will lead the stop. It'll happen when we're facing each other with our shoulders exactly straight on to each other. And it's going to be a quick, slow. So it'll be from your last rock step will have to have been on the leader's right foot.
And the fall is left foot.
So once you finish that rock step, and your feet should be shoulder width apart facing each other, your shoulders are straight on to one another. You can look them in the eye and be like, all right, I'm sick of this move. and you want to kind of increase tension equally on both arms, and that'll signify that they shouldn't do that cross step on the next one. They should just do a in place march into the basic box.
Just demo that on going into it, coming out of it.
Yeah, let's try to do that all together. So we'll start off with one box. We'll do one full box, and then that half box into those parallels. We'll do two regular parallels into two reverse parallels, and then bring it to a stop and go back into the box.
Awesome. Slow, quick, slow, quick,
slow. Quick, one full box,
quick,
half a box,
quick,
regular parallels,
quick,
one more, reverse parallels,
quick,
and then this is our last one,
slow,
march, go, box step,
quick, awesome.
So yeah, that was those parallels, reverse parallels, and the boxes on either side.
Do we have any questions at the moment?
Yeah, music?
Yeah,
let's put on some music and we can practice those at our own pace.
When your legs don't work like they used to before, and I can't sweep you off of your feet, will your mouth still remember the taste of my love? Will your eyes still smile from your cheek? Darling, I will be loving you till 70. Baby, my heart could still feel as hard at 23. I'm thinking about how people fall in love in mysterious ways. Maybe just the touch of a hand. Me, I fall in love with you every single day, and I just wanna tell you I am. So honey, now take me into your loving arms, kiss me under the light of a thousand stars, place your head on my thinking out loud. Maybe we found love right where we are. When my hair's all but gone and my memory fades, and the crowds don't remember my name, when my hands don't play the strings the same way, I know you will still love me the same. Cause honey, your soul could never grow old, it's evergreen. Baby, your smile's forever in my mind and memory. I'm thinking about how people fall in love in mysterious ways, and maybe it's all part of a plan. I'll just keep on making the same mistakes, hoping that you'll understand. baby, we found love right where we
to stick around after this. In a little bit, we're gonna have our intermediate rumba lesson. So there'll be some new moves there that you guys can build upon what we learned today. Otherwise, do we have any other bits of news that we wanna go over?
I'm not sure if you guys are community members or not, but we are taking votes on some constitutional changes. So if you see that come through, go ahead and give it a vote. If you're student member. Otherwise, that's all we have. I just ask that you throw your email in the chat right before you head out, just so I have a way to keep track of attendance for tonight.
All right. It was great having you guys here with us, learning to dance some beginner rumba. Thank you so much for coming. I'm Bailey. I was leading. And
I'm Abby, and I was following.
So, and if you have any feedback, any ways that we can improve our lessons, feel free to email us at tango@uwec.edu. That's probably the best way to get a hold of us.
Everyone says thank you.
Awesome. Have a great night, everybody.
Yeah. Hope
thanks
you have
for
a good
coming.
Thanks. Bye.
Bye.